2012 coverage. It is only one day since the U.S. Senate races were determined. Martin Heinrich and Heather Wilson do agree on one thing already. It is going to get dirty. Action 7 News anchor Tanya Mendez has details on what promises to be one of the hottest races in the country.
Ladies and gentlemen, let the blows begin.
Heather Wilson was spending her career making sure that there were tax breaks for people like Donald Trump.
He's gotten us $5 trillion in debt. He thinks we need to increase taxes and do more spending.
We keep standing up for Social Security and Medicare.
He supported cap and trade and voted against the Keystone Pipeline.
Moments into the race for U.S. Senate, the gloves are off. And as both candidates hit the campaign trail, both say it's going to be an ugly fight.
We're looking forward to contrasting our record to the 11 years that Heather Wilson was in this office.
I suspect that because this will be one of the most competitive Senate races in the country, that there will be all kinds of outside interests from all over the country.
And those outside special interest groups are already pumping millions of dollars worth of attack ads into our state to try to sway this race. No surprise to KOAT political analyst Brian Sanderoff.
Vacant seats don't come around too often. And so when they do, you bet both the Democrats and Republicans, nationally and locally, will fight as hard as they can to win this seat.
Sanderoff says that means political partisan lies at their worst are certain. We'll just have to watch to see who's standing when it's all over. Tanya Mendez, KOAT, Action 7 News.
Sanderoff says Senate races are especially hard fought because whoever secures the win will likely have that seat for decades. He points to Pete Domenici's 36 years in the Senate and Jeff Bingaman's 30 years as examples.